In this lesson, I'll show you how to create chart templates that will help us clone the formatting we've applied to a chart onto other charts in our workbook. To make a template out of our existing chart, we just click onto the chart and then right-click in some of the white space away from the bars as we did before. Click on Save as Template, and then we're going to call it Goat Bars, and then click Save. Excel will save that into the templates area so it can retrieve it later. To show you how easy it is to retrieve a chart format from a template, I've messed up our graph. So to get it back, we just click on it, right click, and then we do change chart type. In there, we've got all the options like column, line, pie chart, and all the standard options in Excel. But if we want to move it back to what we had before in templates, you'll see now that I've got the goat bars when I've just saved. Click on that, click OK, and then it changes it back to as it was. You can see how quick that is and what a useful tool. Not many people know about that in Excel, so I was really keen on showing you. What we're going to do now is change the chart to include duration instead of gross. So to do that, right click anywhere on the chart, you've got to hit a bar in this case and not one of the open areas in the chart, and then click select data, and that will bring up this menu here. If we click on the chart data range box, we'll see that Excel will put a green dotted line in our table to show the data that is being used in our chart. If we then go down to this legend entry series part, and the series is what's representing the values that we're using in our chart, so in this case the gross in millions, if we click edit there, we'll see that it's got dashboard G3, which is the header from the column. And then we've got dashboard G4 to G33, which is the data that we're using as values in our chart. We could change all of those G's to H's, so let me do that now. If we click OK, we'll see that our chart reverts to using the duration column, duration minutes, instead of the gross in million dollars as our values. When we click OK, we'll see also that the blue bars have returned and our data labels have disappeared. That's not a problem because we've saved a template. So right click again, go into change chart type, into templates, and we've got our goat bars one there. Click OK and everything comes back. That's why you save a template. I've just deleted the graph because I want to show you how when you've got templates set up, you can create graphs really quickly for all different elements of the table. So we're going to click on title and we're going to drag it down. This time we're not going to select gross in millions, but we're now going to hold the control key so we can select duration in minutes instead. If we then do insert recommended charts, go to all charts, templates, and then we've got our goat bars one, click OK, and bang, it's back in the format we want it. We can then stretch it to the size we want. We've reproduced that chart for duration in seconds. Earlier on, when we made a chart from data that wasn't stored in a table, Excel didn't know what the data was, and as such, it didn't put a heading in for us. It just said chart title. Whilst we might want to improve this chart title, and we can, it's actually had a stab at it based on the column heading. So that's just another benefit of using tables. In the next lesson, we'll be stepping up the navigation elements of our workbook, and we're going to be introducing buttons. They're going to help us move quickly around the tool that we've made.